You are the great and mighty God. So greatly to be praised, beautiful in our situation. You are the joy of the world. You are the great and mighty God. You are greatly to be praised, beautiful in our situation. You are the joy of the world. You are the great and mighty God. So greatly to be praised, beautiful in our situation.
You are the joy of the world.
Is it the joy of your family?
Yes.
Is it the joy of your home?
Yes.
Then why are you looking at me? Sing it unto you this morning. You are the great and mighty God. So greatly to be praised, beautiful in our situation. You are the joy of the world. You are the great and mighty God. So greatly to be praised, beautiful in our situation. You are the joy of the world. You are the great and mighty God. I am the Lord that healed thee. I am the Lord your healer. I saved my wounds and healed your disease.
Yes, Lord.
I am the same today.
Yeah.
praise.
Amen.
Father, we thank you. We give God the glory.
Amen.
Thank you because of the truth we have experienced your presence here in our midst. Lord, we pray that this your word that is about to come forth. May it come with understanding.
Amen.
May it come now with your glory.
Amen.
That at the end of today's meeting, all glory and honor will be given to your
Amen.
Name. Lord, use me as a vessel unto your honor.
Amen.
Thank you, Father.
Thank you, Lord.
In Jesus' name we pray.
Amen.
Celebrate Jesus and our Jesus. Hallelujah, church. You are all welcome in Jesus' name.
Amen.
God with us.
All the time.
God with us.
All the time.
And all the time.
God with us.
2021.
My year of faith and glory.
When I say my own.
My year of faith and glory.
2021.
My year of faith and glory.
Hallelujah. Please, last week I started a message which I titled what? God bless you. The impossibility specialist. Hallelujah. By the special grace of God, I'm still running through that message this morning. I want to touch some areas that I couldn't touch last week. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
I beg us to understand that nothing is difficult in the hands of our God.
Oh, yes.
And I also make us to understand that in all situations, He is beautiful.
Yes.
I also make us to understand, as our elder said, in all situations, He is able.
Yes.
Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
This God is too big for you and I to comprehend. Like as our papa will say, that we should not think God is with this our small kokoro head. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Now, in a marriage, husband cannot do better without the support of the wife. No matter how skillful the husband is, no matter how hard labor, the man labor, if like he sleep, he doesn't come home, he sleep outside day and night, 24/7, if the wife is not in the same frequency with him, he won't yield fruit. At the end, it will make the man as if he is not working. In all his labor, it will make him, and his efforts will be useless. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
The same thing happens in the hospital. When you go to a hospital, doctor will tell you, please, we need your cooperation. We need you to join us. Praise the Lord. No matter their professionalism, we have professors here, English, correct?
Yeah.
Hallelujah. No matter their professionalism, they will require you. You also have a part to play. Hallelujah. I remember those days when I was small. I was sick. But to the glory of God, since I entered here 2014, I never go hospital one day.
Amen.
Praise the Lord. But when I was a child, I sick. If I tell you I sick, I mean what I am saying. But it comes to a time, it becomes my past. The God of specialists have done a great job in my life.
Amen.
Now, then, you know all these auxiliary nurse, all those laser nurse, all those when they carry some kind back, they not get hospital but the doctor. Hallelujah. In those rural areas in Nigeria. And you know, there are no injection, I don't know whether an iron that they use. Their own injection is different from other injections. When this man, in fact, there is one man in our community, and I believe many communities have such a man, he's a doctor. When we are small, if we see that man, whether we sick, we not sick, everybody, we run. If you pay your father a visit, all of us will go for a hiding, asking questions, who they sick? Because all his visits is for treatment. Praise the Lord. Now, when this man come, if he wants to give me injection, I will touch myself. He will tell me, no, we will spend time in that place. And me, I hate injection. Even medicine, Papa, I don't take. If you enter here,
I won't, no matter if you like, buy the best medicine. If I take it, I will be well. If I didn't take it, the sickness, I will suffer it. Now, when this man will come, he will tell me, please, I need your cooperation. I need you to work with me. Sometimes he begs us with puff puff, with biscuits and other things to pet us. They go back, and that day you go drink Coke. Praise Master Jesus. You will drink much when you not drink since ages. Just to pet you. This is easy to drink much in those days. But to the glory of God, it's like water these days. Hallelujah, church. Now, when you want to put it, if I type myself, it won't work. It won't try. Because if you do, it will wound me. He will make sure that I release myself before he will now inject me. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
The same thing happens that two cannot work except there is agreement. No matter how great God is, if you didn't do your own part, nothing will work. If both of you do not come together, it will make the work of God, it will make God as if he does not do anything. So that is why God, in his way, is seated in heaven. It is you and I that we come with our problem. And whatever he asks us to do, do it. If we say that God is a specialist, he specializes in every situation, that is correct. But he does not happen automatic. Praise the Lord. He does not happen automatic. Every man, every woman must walk in the same frequency with God. The two must come into agreement before his manifestation begins to take place. If God is impossibility specialist, that means I am also impossibility specialist. Hello? That is why Ephesians told us that we can do all things. Ephesians or Philippians, we can do all things through Christ that strengthens us. God can do all things, quite right. Me also can do all things. It takes understanding and to come in that level to begin to operate. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
So, if God is God, that is why he called us gods. We are gods. Hello?
Hi.
That we are gods. And in the Bible, it is he placed G, small letter. Not the Baba own is big G. But when he comes to here, he calls us gods. He puts small G to put us where we still belong. That if we want to be big, we have to, it is in him. Now that we will not get that big G. Hallelujah, church. Are we together?
Yes.
Now, when things of God is happening, you know, many of us, we believe things of the world more than things of the of God. We believe reports of men. There are many of us who hold tradition and believe it even more than the scripture. When it comes to some certain things, you will hear, "Oh, Baba, my father, my mother, elder brother that we call Papa, Uncle, is a native doctor." Okay, which I do got then. And these people, native doctors, when he tells you, there was a day the man gave me a ring. Hello, church.
Hi.
He gave me a ring and said, "This ring will protect you." And the funny thing is that we believe this whole drama. We put all our faith. We spend money with everything within us just to believe man made. Now, the creator himself that made the man that is making you that little something, we will neglect him. Now, when this man gave me this ring, he said, "You will put it in your finger." I'm telling you, I'm not telling you drama. I'm telling you what happens to me. Okay, church. He gave me the ring because I'm a driver. And so that when you are driving, anytime you danger day, when I put it in my hand, I'm not saying danger one day. not saying nothing happened. But my faith in that ring, I trust. In my going out, my eyes is in this place. In such occasion, when you forget such thing in the house, you will go back to go and collect it. Praise the Lord. It will look as if your life is tied in that something. This is man-made. If only we can put our trust the same way we put faith in the things of the world, we could have had more results. When occasion ties us, we run to any man, any woman. They will give us more, one plus and minus will be relieved. What about the scripture? Our elder said something last Friday, two Friday, when he was ministering, that how can we carry good news and expect the bad news? That didn't touch me. I'm having a good news. But it doesn't function that way. You carry Bible, not mean say Bible carry you. Praise the Lord. There are things that you have to do. It's an error for we to call ourselves Christians, carrying Bible, carrying the good news himself. Then, when little shakings, when little issues of the world, it will look as if the world has collapsed upon our head. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Let's read Mark chapter 7. Are we getting understanding?
Oh, yes.
Mark chapter 7. From verse 1. Okay. And I will run to 13. Okay. Then his 10 came together unto him, the Pharisees, and certain of the scribes, which came from Jerusalem. And when they saw some of his disciples eat bread with the fire, Mark 7, verse 1.
Okay, verse 1.
Verse 1. Okay. I said we run to 13. Then came together unto him Pharisees and a certain of the scribes, which came from Jerusalem. And when they saw some of his disciples eat bread with defile, that is to say, with unwashing hands, they found what?
Fault.
For the Pharisees and all the Jews, except they wash their hands oft, if not, holding the tradition of the elders. And when they come from market, except they wash, they eat not. Oh my God. And many other things there be, which they have received to hold, as the washing of cups and pots, brazen vessels, and of tables. Then the Pharisees and the scribes asked him, why work not thy disciples according to the tradition of the elders, but eat bread with unwashing hands? He answered and said unto them, well had Ezekiah, that is Isaiah, prophesied of you hypocrites, as it is written, these people honoreth me with their lips, but their heart is far from me. Let's stop the effects. Amen.
Amen.
People holding tradition of men, but the tradition of God we neglect. They come to church. We come to church, hear preachings, we study the word of God, we listen to messages at home, but still yet, tradition of men stand. This is how we do it. A stolen heart. There are some people, no matter how the message comes, what they believe, they believe.
Yes, sir.
If you like, speak grammar. If you like, speak pidgin. If you like, speak native language. If you like, speak foreign language. That thing they hold on to. They hold on to it. But when it comes to God, it doesn't work that way.
At all.
The word of God is able to pierce in into the marrow. Okay? It is the word of God that can do that. But when it comes to things of God, we neglect it. They hold on to the tradition of men. And if you see this tribe and these people, they are very serious in that business. And nobody they pay them, oh, busybody. been paid, but they are happy in accusing people. They said that was a fine fault. And there are so many of us in the house of God, in the body of Christ, that we find fault in everything that believers are doing. If you go to the internet, that one another war. We were discussing it this morning. If you go to the internet, it's war. People will just pick one message from our elder, 2 seconds, where he was trying to explain something, they'll just pick it and post it. Why will elder say such a thing? Why will Apostle Suleiman say this? Why will this prophet say this? They will always be looking for fault. But God bless you. You can't go to a native doctor place and he say a word and he challenge you. Me too, I find myself there. Whatever he say is yes, Baba. Whatever he say is yes, Baba. It's a place of not going back. Do you know that Ecclesiastes warned us concerning the house of God? He said, when you go to the house of God, he said, sit quietly, pay attention. Don't allow your foot to move around. Be more attention to hear than to speak. Hear, be more attention to hear. When we go to Baba's house, everything is correct. Everything is yes, Baba. Yes, Baba. But when it comes to the word of God, we hold it this way. This one, what is this one saying? What is happening here? What is happening here? They start looking for fault. Fault finders. And whenever you are finding fault, you can't grow. Any man that finds fault can never learn. Because he's seeing the person as inferior. Because whatever you are doing will not please him. So that's what the people cannot learn. So please, if we find ourselves, like our deacon said this morning, the word of God is to build us. Why we come to the house of God is to learn, to see what he's saying to us. And if we find ourselves in it, we retrieve our steps. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
This man, the scribes and the Pharisees, if you watch, if you follow, no matter, even the good of Jesus, they will find fault.
Yes, sir.
Jesus will heal, they will accuse. If Jesus do any miracle, they will accuse. What is their own business in this thing? And the worst part is that they are still believers. So.
Yes.
They are still Jews. But there are certain people. They are teachers. They know the law. They know the word of God. Though. They can quote Genesis to Revelation without reading. If they have been the one now, they will just start quoting without no reading. They know what God says, when he says it, why he says it, at the same time that he says such a thing. But if it comes to obeying it, tradition of men. Tradition of men. You know where I come from? It gets us with the duam. We don't do things this way. It gets us with the duam. For my family, with the duam like this, my brethren, in the things of God, your family is like this. As long as you want to, if you want to be a partaker of God's kingdom, tradition. I get the way I can do my things. When somebody tells you it does not to be so, now lie. Who say? I get the way. Now like this. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Humility. 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 It's good we humble ourselves. Learn from everyone. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Okay, we proceed. Verse 8. For laying aside the commandment of God, ye hold the tradition of men as the washing of pots and cups, and many other such like things ye do. And ye said unto them, full well ye reject the commandment of God, that ye may keep your own tradition. Because you can't serve God and mammon at the same time. It's either you are obeying God or you are obeying mammon. Praise Master Jesus. For Moses said, honor thy father and thy mother, and whoso curseth father or mother, let him die the death. But ye say, if a man shall say to his father or mother, it is Koban. That is to say, a gift. Did you see that? If a child curses his mother, they turn it and they say, a gift. But Moses said, it's wrong. But these people, they will always find their own way. They will only have their own scripture. By whatsoever thou mightest be profited by me, ye shall be free. 12. And ye suffer him no more to do aught for his father or his mother, making the word of God of none effect, through your tradition, which you have delivered, and many such like things do ye. If you must be blessed, if you must come out in every challenge, in every situation, if this God that is impossibility specialist works in you, you must give him permission. I stand at the door. I am knocking. Who opened? I comes in. Who did not open? I won't force myself into him or her. That is our God. Praise the Lord. Because if a man gives you gifts that you didn't require or you are not interested in, you will abuse it. Praise the Lord. So God will like you and I to come to that same frequency. Yes, he is impossibility specialist. He can do everything. He can do this. There are many promises concerning you and I, but it doesn't come automatic. There are works that are required from you and I. Hallelujah. On Wednesday, our deaconess, Faithful, teaches us a message titled, No Death Situation in Christ. In Christ Jesus, there is no death situation. Hallelujah, church. Amen. Then she took us to John. Let's go there. John chapter 11. Let's go and eat a little from waiting our deaconess cook for us last Wednesday. John chapter 11, verse 41 to 42. If you are there, you can read. John 11, 41 to 42.
41.
Yes.
And he said, and Jesus said unto her, 41.
41.
Then they took away the stone from the place where the dead was laid. And Jesus lifted up his eyes and said, Father, I thank thee that thou hast heard me. 42.
Mm-hmm.
And I know that thou hearest me always.
Yes.
But because of the people which stand by, I say it, that they may believe that thou hast sent me.
Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Now, this was the story of Lazarus. Remember, Jesus was invited. Okay? And he told them, roll away the stones. There are things you have to let go. For Lazarus to come out alive, remove these stones. Take away this. Do this and do that. Now, in obedience to his message, there will come results. In the things of God, when you try to do it with your own way, it will not work. In that situation, what is God saying? What is he saying to you? When the ways of a man please God, he maketh him to live in peace with all men. When your ways please God, you don't need too much fasting and prayer. When your way please God, you don't need 200 days to go heaven. There are things that require prayer. There are things that doesn't require prayer. Look at what Jesus said here. Father, I thank you because whenever I call you, you heareth me. How many hours did he pray to raise the dead? Just a word. Just a word and command. When you and I have a good intention, when we make ourselves alright with God, things don't hurt us. But that doesn't mean that challenges will not come. But there will always be a way of escape.
Amen.
So Jesus said, oh, Father, I thank you because whenever I call, you'll always hear me. This is the God we serve.
Amen.
His ear is always open to hear us whenever we cry.
Amen.
He said, call upon me in the days of trouble. I will answer you.
Amen.
He not get trouble, but he knows that you and I will have trouble. Hallelujah.
Amen.
That's why he said, call upon me on that very day. As you are calling me, I am answering to you. Praise Master Jesus. So whatever the occasion might be, whatever it looks like, call upon that name Jehovah. Search yourself. Put yourself in order. Jesus said, the reason why I'm even saying all these things is because of these people. May they not say, now you send me. May they not believe. If not, I would have gone there and said, Lazarus, here, come outside. Because I know who I am. But because of these people, let me just pray this small one. Father, okay, thank you. Because I know whenever I call, you answer. A man that is working with God and a man that is not working with God, they are not the same thing. If me and my wife get quarrel, I go there inside room with her. She go there call me, Daddy. Daddy. I go busy. If I'm doing anything, whether on my laptop or my phone or I'm studying, Daddy, I'm not going to answer. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
In the days of trouble, I have warned you. If you call me, I will not answer you. It is scriptural. Hallelujah. Who bought me? Not be God. Who I go resemble? We are created and made with the image of God. Okay. Hallelujah. Now, do you know that most of us find ourselves in that place? When you are angry with your partner, if you don't call, you're not a minor. Especially you know that you're not in danger. Okay? Even if he's calling, there are some of us, like our thing now, in Nigeria. I believe if the guy needs to issue, if the woman they go, he will leave the phone for one side. If you look at Nashi, go drop her. Because the heart is not in together. They can't work because they are not together. Praise the Lord. So my wife, since you are here, anytime when you call me and not answer, no say sakaladeo. So send a friend, come on, go answer. Hallelujah, church. The Bible said, if you call, I have warned you.
Yes.
To stay away from this thing. You're not here. If you call, I'm not going to answer you. But if you are in doing the right thing, before you call self, because my eyes are upon the righteous, like satellites, I'm watching over my people.
Amen.
I'm watching over them. I am watching over you. 24/7. Before you call, I know that thing will happen. I'm there with you. Behold, I'm with you always.
Amen.
These are scriptures. I am with you always. In that day situation, we still have said anything. That one at their own. Landlord said, make you back. That one I know business.
Yes.
I know the God I serve. Yes. He never leave me as an orphan. He will not forsake me. He never forsake those that put their trust in him. It's only if your trust is not in him.
Yes.
If your trust is in him, you will have confidence.
Yes.
You have boldness. Why others are crying for issues of the life or whatsoever? You, they will look at you as an abnormal person. Yes, that is who I am.
Yes.
I'm abnormal because we are not from the same place.
At all.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
The Jews in Mark where we read, some disciples of Jesus went and washed hands because that's the way tradition of men.
Yes.
But they abort that just to fulfill God's own. But people were still there saying, no, you're supposed to wash hands. You're supposed to do this. You're supposed to do that. Praise Master Jesus.
Hallelujah.
To walk in God, if we really say we follow things of God, we're not going to wear cloth. We're not going to wear cloth. If things of God like madness is contrary to the things of men. They are not the same. If man is going this way, Jesus, that's why, don't you blame the Pharisees, though, because they were walking humanly.
Yes.
But it takes us, the Bible says, ye are gods, but because you do not follow me, you will die as men. In other words, what happened to men will also happen to you. But if you follow me as I have called you, as I have pronounced you, the things that will be happening to men, you will not be found in it.
Amen.
Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
So that is why our mindset matters a lot.
Yes.
If God can raise a document that have died for 5 years, doctor, lawyer say nothing.
Yes.
Professionals or whatever say nothing. offices, CGM, whosoever, all of them say no hope. But the man still determined that I know the God I serve. It determined. But today, victory has taken place.
Amen.
Hallelujah. Please, let's now, even in that Wednesday, Dickness took us to John chapter 5 of a man that was sick for a whole 38 years. You don't begin of 38 years, you don't need to marry.
Yes.
Sickness of 38 years. But at encounter with the master, Jesus was here on earth as a man.
Yes.
Not as a God though.
At all.
But because he separated himself from men, that was able to achieve those results.
Amen.
Then Peter, Paul, and others, they were still men. In the same way now that some of us are doing some certain things, putting it on the internet. Tomorrow, some people will come and read those your history.
Yes.
People will come and see your name on social media, see your Facebook, see the things you post, whether good
or bad.
If you post nakedness today, tomorrow, children, generation will come to see it. If you post something that come up God, men, children will come in the nearest future to come and read your story.
Amen.
Instead of you are reading their manner and others.
Yes.
Praise Master Jesus.
Hallelujah.
Finally, let's see Matthew chapter 5 verse 8. In prayers, weekly, monthly prayer, our brother Gideon took us to this place. Matthew chapter 5 verse 8. Yes, you can read Matthew 5 verse 8. Thank you. Yes.
Blessed are the pure in heart, for they shall see God.
God. Blessed are they that have pure hearts, for they shall see God. For me, prayer is good, but it will be much more better if your heart is pure. Even praying, if your heart is not pure, God will not hear you. So what's the essence of praying? So the foundation, please take care of the child. The foundation is making your heart pure before God. When your heart is pure before God, the Bible says you will thank God.
Amen.
When you say anything, heaven will honor it.
Amen.
If your heart is pure towards God, you don't waste 100 years in praying. You don't waste 100 years in speaking in tongues and all that. They are good, okay? I'm not saying they are not good. But what will it be if your heart is not okay? If your heart is polluted with a brother or a sister, if your heart, there are grudges in it because the brother says something and you get offended. And do you know the worst part of it, that the brother might not even know?
Oh, yes.
He will go home and start eating and celebrating. That is why Jesus said in Matthew, if your brother offends you, go and tell him his fault. Because your brother might not know.
Yes.
When I was reading that place, I said, Jesus, you know one day by us here, he offend me. Me go tell him his fault again. Not be supposed to come tell me, say, sorry, I offend you.
Yes.
But while I go deeper, I find out that your brother might be ignorant that he offended you. That is why you should go and tell him, brother, look at what you did. That the brother will ask, oh, I don't know. There are many things like that.
Oh, yeah. Yes.
Oh, I don't know. I am sorry. A very practical of it. From yesterday, our brother Joe came. He said, Edgar, you didn't call me on Friday because I told you I was not feeling too strong. I bring out my phone. I called you on Friday evening around 10. You didn't pick. I called you yesterday on WhatsApp. You didn't pick. In the afternoon, I still called you. You didn't pick. He was like, I don't know. Now, he now said, because my phone, the phone was with my wife. Now, for example, he didn't tell me. Would he have been going with that mentality that this man didn't call me? And he would be keeping malice While me, I'm progressing. Me, I'm advancing. I'm using him as a point of contact, okay? For us, because it's what happened yesterday in Choir Practice. Now, I will be advancing. Doing, I'll even see him greet him. He might greet me like say he greet me, but in his heart, he not greet me. But me, I'm rejoicing in my heart with gladness. Because you know when you are in glad mood, like some of us when they go shoro, if you are happy, that day always be different from the day you find your face. The day you find your face, that people doesn't care. They don't think I yet. And as you take front and gun, I say you go take front and gun. Like one day, that day jam me in train station. Then he said, I'm thinking, why your face be like, I say, God disappoint you. Hallelujah. Because some days are like that. But in all, we move.
Amen.
Hallelujah, church. Amen. So please, above all the grammar that I'm speaking, the summary of it all is that there is nothing God cannot do.
Amen.
And you also, there is nothing you cannot do.
Amen.
That's what Philippians told us. But it takes you and I to come into that level, into that realm, to make sure that things work through in good.
Amen.
Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Renew yourself. Renew your mind.
Renew your mind.
It's one of the scriptures I also love. Renew every day. Because God knows that some things go still enter. Creeping things. If they enter, you're not going to know. And they're not the ring bell before they come. So it takes, when you renew your mind, wash away some certain things. Let them go. There are some medicine when they come and tell me, I'm washing and setting. Are they exposed all of now? Hallelujah, church. Now, if human beings who know that there is something to wash and reset, an English come this period, they say sanitize your hand. Why? So that infection will not come.
Yes.
If you also sanitize your heart, the devil will not also come in. Hallelujah.
Yeah.
So, please. Things of God, it be not hard though. Jesus said, take my yoke, it's soft. Take my burden is not heavy. He knows that we will complain. That's why he makes us know that these things are very simple. My burden, and they don't have weight. If only you can be following it slow and steady. Whatsoever the occasion demand. When a brother sin against you or offend you, just let go. There was a day our daddy called me. He gave me a message during December or something to preach. Something happened before then, before the day. On Saturday afternoon, I called daddy. Daddy, please, yo, I'm supposed to minister tomorrow. I can't. Why? Because my heart, there is something in my heart. And I can't stand in the presence of God and preach. If I do that, it will be error, wasting of time. He said, God also conquered me. But I don't want to incur the wrath of God. I want, if I'm preaching, if I'm praying, even if I say one word, I will know what I'm saying.
Yes.
Without no accuser from any brother.
Amen.
The devil himself.
Yes.
When I'm preaching, I won't preach. If for example, you offend me now. If I'm preaching, I will be dodging not to say that thing.
Exactly.
Do you understand? So that you will not say it's because of you. But if I don't have anything against you, I will say it the way it comes. Hallelujah. So that is why we also have to purge ourselves. So that when we are moving, we will be moving with confidence.
Yes.